The best landing spots for rookie wide receivers next on FFT in 5. What's going on, everybody? Dave Richard, joined by the man himself, Emory Hunt, going over the rookie wide receivers that have good landing spots. That matters for fantasy football. You don't want to get a wide receiver that's got a crummy landing spot. He's not going to help you win your fantasy league. Emory, the first rookie, maybe the best rookie that has the best landing spot in your opinion,
is probably Zay Flowers. When you think about what's on side of him with OBJ and also Rashad Bateman coming back healthy, a paid Lamar Jackson, you're going to have your tight end, taking pressure off the outside as well, and Mark Andrews. So, yes, he lands in a great spot because he's a point-and-shoot type guy. He can catch and run and should do a great job in that offense, whatever that offense looks like, because it's a new offensive coordinator. But he should win those one-on-one matchups with these.
Odell Beckham's on a one-year deal. We don't know what his future is. Rashad Bateman could be off the team in 2 years. And Lamar Jackson, people forget about this, Emory. At least a 62% completion rate each of the last four seasons. It's been closer to 65% in three of the last four. That's name number one. Name number two, rookie wide receiver with a great landing spot.
I'm going to go with Jaxon Smith-Njigba because he's the third guy amongst two excellent receiving options in Tyler Lockett and DK Metcalf. We saw what happens when one is maybe a little bit banged up and the other tends to get a little bit banged up, or unless the defensive back gets in his head and he's off to doing something else. They needed another guy, and they got the best guy in the class outside of Flowers, in my opinion. He was my number two overall prospect at the position. But you talk about someone that could play outside or inside, and when you look at where the Seahawks can win now, they can win over the middle of the field, shallow, intermediate, and also deep with someone like Jaxon Smith-Njigba.
And honestly, I feel like he's their solution when teams play cover two against them and they really clamp down on Lockett and DK Metcalf. Plus, we know that Tyler Lockett's on the wrong side of 30. Not sure how much longer he'll be in Seattle. I think that there is a real pathway for Jaxon Smith-Njigba to be great in Seattle. And for his rookie year, maybe not as exciting, maybe a double-digit round pick. But long-term, I'm in a rookie-only draft, Emory. I would be willing to take JSN as high as third overall in that one QB dynasty rookie-only draft that I'm in. The fourth rookie. Are we on fourth or are we on third? I'm not even sure anymore. I think it's third, Emory. Help me out here. Let's do some counting. And who's the rookie wide receiver that you like?
I'm going to go with Quentin Johnston out of TCU. I feel like people are looking at this the wrong way. They're looking at this as, okay, he's a vertical threat. Yes, he can be that. But I feel like he catches the football not cleanly, so he's not your 50-50 guy. So I think he's more of a catch-and-run guy. We saw glimpses of this a lot of times in his college career, but more emphatically against Michigan, taking a shallow crosser and going the rest of the way, 70-plus yards for a touchdown. All health being, if all things being considered health-wise, if those two guys that tend to be banged up a lot stay out there, he's your third option, and he's going to be killer on those slants, those crossers, those in routes. I think he has a chance to really, blossom and play well within this offense.
Would you agree that he's a big receiver that plays like a small receiver?
Absolutely. You can see that when how he goes up to attack the football. He's jumping up, but he's trying to catch it as if he's cradling it with his body. So, yeah, he tends to play small. That's why I compared his – I think he doesn't trust his hands too much. I more compared him to Torrey Smith, and Torrey Smith had a fantastic long career in the NFL. He'll grow and get more confident with his hands, as did Torrey Smith as he got older.
And if he does that, he'll be the number one receiver for Justin Herbert. And that's not a bad thing to be if you're looking for stats in fantasy football. We know that Keenan Allen, one of the older receivers in the NFL, Mike Williams, he'll be 30 next year. He'll also be in a contract year next year. And actually, believe it or not, the Chargers can move on from Mike Williams after this year. I think Quentin Johnston, if he plays well, they might do that. Do you have any other rookie wide receivers with great landing spots for us?
Yeah, this is off the radar. This is Michael Wilson of Stanford going to Arizona. Oh. We still don't know what's going on with DeAndre Hopkins, whether he's going to be there or not. Let's say he's moved before the season starts. They need someone that could be that X guy. And lo and behold, they have my number one X receiver in Michael Wilson landing there. The thing about him, have to put the asterisk by it, if he stays healthy. That was his whole thing at Stanford, which is why he also dropped in the draft. But if he's out there, he is a fantastic receiver that can do all things and do all things extremely well.
6'2", 216 pounds, great sleeper for those dynasty leagues. Don't see him making an impact, at least not in the early portion of 2023 seasons. Can I give you one more, Emory? One other receiver. I like the landing spot for Jonathan Mingo. I look at the other wide receivers in Carolina, and I see guys that can help a little bit this year. You know, Adam Thielen will be a security blanket, DJ Chark a downfield threat. But the guy that's got the long-term trajectory with Bryce Young, with the coaching staff that just picked him, is Mingo. And we know that Frank Reich, I think he's got a type, Emory. He likes those big physical wide receivers, and that's what Mingo is. So I think he'll have an opportunity to get anywhere between 100 and 120 targets, maybe each of the next three seasons. And with that type of optimism, I think Mingo's worth taking with a first-round pick in rookie-only drafts and with a late-round pick in redraft leagues. That'll do it for this edition of FFT and 5. Tons more coming at you this week and beyond as we start with that focus of getting you ready for your fantasy leagues in 2023. Thanks for watching and listening.